Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, these chambers, together with our sister chamber, the House of Representatives, passed a law called the Legislative Houses Powers and Privileges Act 2017. It was duly signed by the President of this Republic, President Buhari, and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. So it is a law of this country, still operational. I'll just read one or two sections. You'll be able to draw home essentially what is necessary to be done at this instance. Section 8 says, a member of a legislative house shall not be obstructed or hindered from gaining entrance into the legislative chambers. This includes House of Assemblies. And a person who hinders the movement of a member of a legislative house into the chambers or premises of a legislative house, or who interferes or disobeys the order given by an officer of a legislative house in performing his official functions, or who creates any disturbance which interrupts or is likely to interrupt the proceedings of a legislative house, commits an offense and is liable on conviction to a fine not exceeding 100,000 or a term of imprisonment for 6 months or both. And an officer of the legislative house may, with or without an order from court and warrant of arrest, as provided in schedule to this act, arrest any person who commits an offense contrary to the provisions of this act. Sir, the society, including our own, hold dearly the sanctity of the legislative house. And they believe, essentially, that democracy can only thrive where we have a legislative house, a parliament, whatever name so called. And until we begin to respect this view, then we must be threatening our democracy. So it is wrong, I submit, sir, for any authority whatsoever to try to stop members from sitting or stop a member from going to the job for which has been elected by his people. And that is basically why this law was enacted. And the president did not waste time in signing this into law. So I believe that police authorities not need to know that whoever is stopping the legislative house in the Akwaibom or members from sitting is risking 6 months imprisonment. And the speaker of that parliament can on his own arrest everybody who is there, or that for the arrest, who is trying to stop them from doing their work. That is what our law provides. So and I think that this step must be taken to ensure that this aspect of our law is implemented. There are other very noble provisions in this act, and I suggest that every member of this House, and possibly every member of the legislative in Nigeria, should arm himself with this piece of legislation. It is something that will safeguard our democracy. It will safeguard the sanctity of the hallowed chambers of the legislative houses. So I think, my colleagues, that this is time for us to stand up for our democracy. It does not matter which party is involved. It does not matter which level of government is involved. It does not matter which part of Nigeria it is involved. Our democracy will be at risk if we keep quiet in matters that concern one part of Nigeria, and because it doesn't concern us, and then we now think that it's all good. I think it's now for us to stand up for our democracy to ensure that the correct thing is being done. It may be Akwaibom today, it may be under state tomorrow. So I submit that we need to ensure that the members of the State House of Assembly in Akwaibom will be given a conducive atmosphere to sit and do the legislative business for which they are elected.
Distinguished colleagues,